application of differential equations, in this case to a mixing problem. Now, mixing problems often cause a little trouble, but the basic idea is usually quite simple. You essentially model the rate of change of some amount, and you should always use an amount, not a concentration, as what's coming in minus what's coming out. In this particular mixing problem, what we've got is a tank that's to hold at most 100 litres, and initially it's got 50 litres of pure water inside it. Brine, that's a mixture of salt and water of course, is running at a rate of 3 litres a minute, and this brine contains 2 grams of salt per litre. The mixture is then stirred continuously. In mixing problems we usually assume that mixtures are stirred continuously, so that we don't have to worry about concentrations being different at different parts of the vessel in this case. So the mixture is stirred and then run off at 1 litre a minute. And our problem here is twofold. We're asked firstly to set up a differential equation to model this system, and then to work out exactly how much salt there is in the tank at the point where it overflows. And this problem tells us that we should let x of t be the amount of salt measured in grams, where t is measured, the time is measured in minutes. But that's all part of the problem. If that wasn't in the problem, that's how you'd want to set it up. Grams of salt and time in minutes. So, the first thing we're going to do is actually write that down. Write down our variable. So we will say, let x of t be the amount of salt in the tank at time t in minutes, x is in grams. Forgive me for using the European spelling of grams there. You should always explain what your symbols mean. Right? In any word problem, half of the problem is translating the words into mathematics, but you've got to explain how you're doing that. That's part of the issue. All right, so to set up the differential equation, with mixing problems, as I said, these things are usually the same differential equations. We can write it as dx dt is the inflow minus the outflow, what's coming in minus what's coming out. It's always that simple. The question then is to work out what's coming in and what's coming out. Well, the problem tells us that brine is being run in at 3 litres a minute, and the brine contains 2 grams per litre, so we're having 3 times 2, 6 grams of salt arriving every minute. So we'll write this down as 3 by 2, just to remind ourselves that's where it comes from. And then what's going out? Well, what's going out is 1 litre a minute. So what we need to know is the concentration of salt inside the tank. Well, the concentration of salt is however much salt there is divided by the volume of liquid in there. We'll work out, because the volume of liquid here is changing, it's not constant as it is in some problems. And the other thing we know, because these problems are always initial value problems, is how much salt is there in the beginning. Well, we know that we had 50 litres of pure water, so we know that x of 0 was 0. There was no salt in the tank when we began. So all we need to do now to set up a differential equation finally is to write down what the volume would be at time t. Well, we started off with 50 litres. We're running in 3 litres a minute and pouring out 1 litre a minute, so our net gain is 2 litres of fluid a minute. So this is our differential equation, dx dt is 6 minus x over 50 plus 2t. x of 0 equals 0. So that's the first part of the problem done. We've set up the differential equation. The second part of the problem asked us to find out how much salt there was left in when the tank overflowed. Well, our first problem, of course, is to work out when does the tank overflow. The tank is a 100-litre tank, and the volume is 50 plus 2t, that's in litres, of course. So quite clearly, the tank's going to overflow when t is 25. That's 25 minutes, of course. We want to solve the differential equation. Well, this differential equation is a linear differential equation. If we move the x over 50 plus 2t to the other side, we get in exactly the correct shape for a linear differential equation. So the differential equation is linear dx dt plus x over 50 plus 2t is equal to 6. And we solve linear differential equations using an integrating factor. We need to integrate, in this case, 1 over 50 plus 2t with respect to t, and take the exponential of that. So the integrating factor is x of the integral 1 over 50 plus 2d, plus 2t, sorry, dt. Well, integrate 1 over 50 plus 2t with respect to t, and we're going to get 1/2 log of 50 plus 2t, take the exponential of that, and we're going to get 50 plus 2t to the power of half, or the square root of 50 plus 2t. Yeah, you don't need to bother about an arbitrary constant when you're finding integrating factors. That would just multiply the whole equation through by something arbitrary, and there's no point doing that. Okay, so for a linear DE, when we have the integrating factor, we need to just multiply the whole differential equation through by this integrating factor. The point of that being that that makes, in this case, the left-hand side, just d by dt of x times the integrating factor. So there's no point writing anything else down, you might as well just write that down. So multiplying by through, we get d by dt of x into 50 plus 2t to the half is equal to 6 times 50 plus 2t to the half. This is our differential equation. Well, left hand side, simple enough. We'll integrate with respect to t. We're going to integrate this side with respect to t as well. So we get x times 50 plus 2t to the half is equal to, well, that will be 50 plus 2t to the 3/2, and when we sort the arbitrary constants out, we'll find we'll need a 2 here, I think, won't we? Yep, we will. Plus, of course, not an arbitrary constant, I mean the multiplying constant. We get a C on this side. So that's our differential equation solved. It's an initial value problem though, so we need to work out what C is. Well, our initial value is that x of 0 is 0, so we put t equals 0 in here. This side will just be 0, and this side will get twice 50 to the 3/2 is equal to C. So as x of 0 equals 0, we get 0 equals, well, 2 times 50 to the 3/2, well, 50 is twice 25, and when we take 25 to the 3/2, we get, what do we get here? Well, let me just write that down that way, 50 to the 3/2 plus c. Might as well leave it like that, I suppose. So that tells us the arbitrary constant is minus twice 50 to the 3 halves, which is 500 root 2, isn't it? So now we have C, we could, if we wanted, put this into our solution and solve it and get an explicit function for x. In this case, we only need to know what x at 25 is, so we might as well just do that. So x of 25 times, well, put t equals 25 in here and we get 100 to the half, so that's going to be x of 25 times 10, and on the other side we get 2 times 100 to the 3 halves, which is 2 times 1,000, minus RC, 500 root 2, divide through by the 10, and we get exactly the answer that the question asked us to get. X at 25 is 200 minus 50 root 2. And that's the amount of salt in the tank at the point where it overflows. So just a brief recap. These mixing problems, invariably in the shape, what comes in minus what goes out, and what comes in, or what comes out for that matter, is usually a product of an amount and concentration. But whenever you're doing these problems, it's invariably easier to calculate in terms of amount of substance, not concentrations.